Hello and welcome to MOOC's program on Information and Communication Technology. I'm Dr. Aparajita Bhatt from National Law University, Delhi. I'm going to introduce this course on ICT or Information and Communication Technology. Cyber law or ICT is not a very old subject, as you know, among the list of other existing subjects. It's a very recent phenomena. As we know that technology is changing on a daily basis, law and especially cyber law is also required to keep pace with the changes in the upcoming technology. This MOOC's course on ICT intends to create not only awareness but also a legal understanding of various issues, various important and significant issues of cyber law, such as e-commerce, online privacy issues, cloud computing, various cyber crimes, cyber contraventions, online frauds, etc. This course would be beneficial for UG and PG students of law. This would also be beneficial for people from corporate background, so also for lawyers and any other interested candidate as well. The learning objectives of this course are to understand the law relating to information technology, to understand the challenges in the area of cyber law, to understand the different facets of cybercrime and learn about their prevention, to understand the concept and issues related to net neutrality, internet governance, electronic governance, etc., to make a comparative study with US, UK and other jurisdictions, to understand the issues related to jurisdiction in cyberspace, to understand issues related to e-commerce, and to educate about the regulation of cyberspace both at national as well as international level. Now, the course plan of ICT stretches to 15 weeks. It's a 15-week program. In week 1, we shall be covering two modules, module 1 and 2. Module 1 on jurisprudence and scope of cyber law. Module 2 on internet governance. Week 2, we would cover yet another two modules. One on jurisdictional issues in cyberspace and module 4 on case laws on jurisdiction in cyberspace. Week 3, we would discuss three modules, 5, 6 and 7. Module 5, overview of Indian Information Technology Act. Module 6, digital and electronic signatures. Module 7, adjudication and online dispute resolution. Week 4, yet another three modules, 8, 9 and 10. Module 8 on e-commerce, concept and issues. Module 9, taxation issues related to e-commerce. And module 10, financial frauds and e-commerce. In week 5, we'll be discussing two modules, 11 and 12, consumer protection under module 11, consumer protection in cyberspace, and e-contracts, that would be module 12. Week 9, but before that, we have week 8, where we'll not discuss any module, that would be the revision and assessment week. In week 9, we would be discussing three modules, 19, 20 and 21. Module 19, cyber pornography and obscenity. Module 20, cyber terrorism. Module 21, liability of intermediaries. Week 10, we will be discussing two modules, 22 and 23. Module 22 on computer forensics and module 23 on digital evidence broad principles. Week 11, we would be discussing three modules. Module 24, cyberspace and copyright law. Module 25, patent law in cyberspace, and module 26, trademark law and cyberspace. Week 12, we would be discussing another set of modules, international cyber law US, which would be module 27. Module 28 would be international cyber law UK, and module 29 would be international cyber law other jurisdictions. In week 13, we'll be discussing four important topics under four modules. Module number 30 on online profiling, module 31, cloud computing, module 32, online privacy issues and data protection law in India, and module 33, cyber security. Finally, week 14, two another modules, 34 and 35, module 34, net neutrality, and module 35, electronic governance. And finally, we reach the last week, week 15, where we'll not discuss any module. That would be the revision, assessment and evaluation week. This course on ICT under the MOOCs program carries 4 credit points. And as you know, it's a 15-week duration course, there would be weekly formative and summative assessment at the end of every week. You shall also be provided with e-text for every module, with video, with the release of video, and with further readings and references which will be important for additional knowledge with every module in every week. And at the end of every week, there would be a small assessment so that you can assess yourself. And finally, in the end, there would be a small examination wherein the assessment would be done by us, by the evaluators. So this MOOCs course on Information and Communication Technology is going to be a very interesting, very exciting course, a very good learning experience for you. I wish you all the very best for this learning experience in order to attend this course on ICT. Thank you.